I was feeling so overwhelmed by the closet in my boys' bedroom. It had their clothes in it, my out-of-season clothes, books, toys, gift bags, wrapping supplies, linens, like keepsake items, pretty much anything that I didn't have a great place for but went into this closet. Let's just say it was the perfect dumping grounds behind closed doors. However, I knew that it was the biggest closet in our house, and it just was not functioning well, and I needed it to. So, I am going to share with you how I transformed my boys' bedroom closet into a storage closet for toys, books, clothes, and some less frequently used items. I'm going to give you all of my steps and things that I was thinking through along the way to make this a functional, beautiful space that I now enjoy going to, and I enjoy opening this closet door. The first thing I did was I assessed the space that we had to work with. So I assessed the storage units that we had. So as you see here, I had this dresser in this space, and that was pretty much it, other than the hanging shelf at the top of the closet, which was here when we bought the house. We really have done nothing to this closet other than that. I was also thinking about how I wanted this space to function. So that led me to what pieces I needed to invest in. So the first thing was I wanted to get the boys' day-to-day clothes out of the closet. I wanted less visual stimulation around getting dressed in the morning for them. So we got a dresser slash wardrobe for out in the main part of their bedroom. And I totally transformed that dresser to be a functional, practical Montessori wardrobe for our twins. If you didn't see that video, I'll link it up here in the cards for you. And some of my biggest pain points with this closet was that I didn't have storage for books and toys that was effective. So I really wanted to solve that problem. So we found this IKEA Calyx shelf for a really great deal on Facebook Marketplace. My husband graciously went to go pick it up, and we moved the dresser out of this closet and actually put it in my closet, which worked much better. It replaced an older and quite janky dresser that we had been using, which we were able to resell on Facebook, actually. And we now have this cube storage shelf in the boys' bedroom. So now that I had my storage unit in place, I was ready to start organizing and decluttering. And I just want to be transparent here. This closet organization did not happen in one day. This took me almost 3 weeks, you guys. And obviously, I wasn't working on it all of those 3 weeks, but I was working on it in little bits and pieces as I had time to do so. And I also needed that time to think about how I wanted it to function because I want things to function well, to be beautiful, and that takes time to figure out what orientation, what arrangement works for that. It's a lot of trial and error. There's many ways to go about doing an organizing project, and honestly, like I said, you just kind of have to try different things with your items and your space and your containers that you have. And I can't tell you just like how many different times I would try different arrangements or different locations of how to store things. And it probably is going to change again because our needs are going to change. Maybe the number of children we have will change. And it's just a constant juggling of how to store things. So, for me, when I am organizing something, though, I consider a few things. So, one thing that's just an obvious question is like, does this make sense? Does storing these objects make sense in this room? Do those items belong in this room or closet? And so I filtered a lot of things through that lens, which helped me to get items out of the room that didn't belong. I like to keep a laundry basket with me when I'm reorganizing a space because then I can just place any items that don't belong or that need to be given away in the laundry basket and I can get them out of that space and deal with them often at another time. That just helps me to minimize the amount of stuff that I am working with. So when you get clear on what you want stored in one place, it makes it easier to remove items. You'll also want to get rid of anything that you no longer want or need. And to be honest, you could have the most organized house, but you don't need to organize things that you don't use. So be disciplined in this part of the process of just purging and getting rid of anything that you don't need, that you've outgrown, that doesn't meet your family's needs at this moment, and then you can part with those objects. So then you'll need to look at the space that you have to work with and finding storage bins and baskets that work for you and meet those needs. So I went with a combination of these cloth cube baskets, and I also got these snap clear lid bins from Costco. They came in a pack of four for like $10, really reasonable. And they're not as pretty as those cube ones, but they fit perfectly in here. I can stack two on top of one another. They're see-through, which allows me to see what's inside of them. And they hold toys and activities really well. So then you can go back through and add just little touches of beauty by placing little artifacts or a small picture in front of something. I did this on areas that are still out of reach of my boys. This might not be possible depending on this location or just how you want the space to function, but it helps me to have these little beautiful parts of a closet. You'll notice I also have a lot of empty bins on my shelves, and this is really intentional. I find myself frustrated when I fill closets or cabinets too full. Then anytime I get something new, I have to reorganize the whole entire room to get it to fit. And so I wanted to try to avoid that happening this time and just anticipate the fact that we will get more toys because my boys are still very young. They're only 14 months old. I know that there are many more birthdays and Christmases ahead of us, so I just anticipate more toys coming in. I also anticipate more children, which is why I have also chosen to store all of our baby clothes and baby items. Naturally, when I don't need to hold on to all of these items, there will be less to store, but that could be many, many years down the road. So I really am trying to make it work for the long haul here. You'll notice as I am organizing this closet that sometimes I try things one way and then you might see it different later on. That's because I'm sharing with you really the process of organizing, and it's a process. You try things one way and then you don't like that, and so you try it another way. Earlier you saw me putting some clothes in those cube baskets, and I actually ended up changing that because I thought about it more and realized that those clothes that I was putting in there, one was a basket of things that were too small and that I needed to store into our larger bins, and the other basket was of clothes that were still a little bit too big but were on the current size and season that they were in. And I realized that I wanted those more easily accessible, and so instead I put out a wicker basket for those clothes that they outgrew, and then a smaller one with some that will fit them very soon. And I just put those within their wardrobe, and that works so much better because I really want this closet to function more as a storage place rather than somewhere I'm always going in every day. And that was a really good adjustment that I made. As you can see, I like to label my bins just so I know what is in them. If you don't have a labeler, I highly recommend it. Notice here I have changed the top of this many, many times, and that's just part of the process of figuring out what you like, what you don't like. And I also need to get another one of those cubes, but I didn't have the opportunity to get to the store, so we will have to do that next time we're out. I just hope that this video maybe inspires you of how you can start thinking about how to organize your space. But it's going to look very different potentially than mine does because you have a whole different set of needs and belongings and space allotments. And so it's going to naturally look very different, but the principles will be similar. So now that this closet is finished, I feel so much better entering into my boys' rooms or putting a toy away. It also makes it a lot more fun to rotate toys, and I know exactly where everything is. Thank you for watching today's video. I hope it helped you feel more confident in how to approach organizing a closet to meet your needs. I will see you next Friday for another Montessori-inspired homemaking video. If that is something that you're interested in, hit that subscribe button and that little bell to be notified when a new video comes out, which is every Friday. So thank you for stopping by our Montessori home. Have a great day.